Hey guys and girls, this is Anish from gainmedialab.com. Welcome to my exciting world of live audio mixing. In today's video, I talk about the difference between DCAs and mix buses. But before we go into all that, make sure that you have subscribed to this channel and turned on the notification bell so that you don't miss any of the audio deliciousness coming your way every Monday. With all that out of the way, let's just start the video. Quite a few of my students from my online courses asked me to explain the difference between DCAs and mix buses. They get used in digital console work for live sound, especially when we are dealing with larger input channel counts. Because we as people just have two hands, yet we have to control increasing amounts of input channels. When we just had like 10 or 16 channels that could have been managed with, you know, just looking at one layer at a time. But now that digital consoles have layers and you have to flip through them, these things can get quite out of hand if you don't have a system in place where you can sort of reduce the number of channels that you can control and keep an eye on during your performance. And this is where grouping things into mix buses or just controlling them with DCA faders comes very handy, and we use them all the time in various scenarios across all types of live sound work. Let's just talk briefly about what DCA means. It's an abbreviation or an acronym for digitally controlled amplifier, and it is remnant of something that was known in the analog world as VCAs, voltage controlled amplifier. Now, because in the audio world, we don't have standardization in place for naming these things, some manufacturers, even on digital consoles, will still name these VCAs, creating confusion among the users, but they are the same thing. So DCAs and VCAs on digital consoles mean the same thing. They are digitally controlled amplifiers, and on the analog boards, they will be VCAs or voltage controlled amplifiers, but they do the same job. The naming confusion can also be found on the mix bus side. Now, the mix bus as a term is a general term that just means an audio path. Mix bus can mean a master bus. It can also mean an auxiliary send. It can also mean a subgroup. All of these terms are sort of included when we say mix bus. And this is where the main difference lies between a DCA group and a mix bus or a subgroup. The DCA is only a remote control for your faders. It is as if you were still holding your fingers on all of the channels that are assigned to that DCA and pulling them up and down in relation to each other in terms of value. So the dB offset between various faders will remain the same when you are using DCA. DCAs is basically remote controls for numbers of channels on your console. They do not influence the audio path, and they do not influence any processing for these channels on their own. On the other hand, a mix bus is an additional audio path. It means that you are actually routing the audio signal from the input channels to another place on your mixing console. If you consider that the term mix bus also includes auxiliary sends, that might sort of clarify things a bit. So just consider your standard setting on your console where all of your input channels are routed to the main bus or the left-right bus, and then you have to run monitors, and you want to route that particular signal from the input channel in addition to the left-right main bus into another auxiliary send. And that is what a mix bus is. It is just an alternate audio path for your input signal. Now, the main confusion comes usually when we talk about DCAs versus subgroups, because subgroups can sometimes behave in a similar fashion than DCAs, right? The difference between the DCA and a subgroup is that the subgroup, when you know various channels are assigned to that subgroup, that will be an additional audio path. And as an additional audio path, it can receive the same processing as an input channel or as a main left-right bus. Let's demonstrate this on the offline software for this console. These dark channels with green writings on it are input channels. We have a drum DCA where all of these channels are assigned to it. You can see that all of these numbers mean DCA assignment. And then all of the outputs from these channels also go into a drum bus and into a left-right bus. So the signal path is from all of these input channels. The output post fader will go into this drum bus, and the output of this drum bus will go into the left-right main bus. They are also controlled, so these input channels are also controlled by a DCA fader. So when I click on these input channels, you can see all of the processing available to me. And all of this processing is available to me because this is an audio path and we can influence audio, right? But when I click on the DCA, and I'm clicking on this DCA right now, nothing happens. There are no options to apply processing to this DCA because this is not an audio path. This is only a remote control for all of these channel faders and only faders. So dragging this DCA fader down is the same as dragging all of these 10 faders down in perfect relationship to each other, right? So the dB offset between these channels remains the same. But when I click on this drum bus, however, you can see that now processing is available to me. I can go into the EQ, I can go into the dynamics and apply, you know, additional processing to this drum bus. And this will influence the combined sound of all of these channels. An added curiosity for this is when we look at the drum bus, you can see that I can also send this bus into various matrices, meaning I can also create another audio path from this particular path on the console. So how does that distinction actually work in real life? What does that mean for our workflow? Well, if you have channels that you know you will have to process as a group, for example, if you have a string section of four violins and you want to control the sound of those violins, then you have to create a mix bus for those violins where you can add compression or EQ changes to that particular mix bus. If you only want to control the level of those strings, however, you can get away with just controlling the DCA. So you can assign those faders to a DCA group and just control the levels. And that is the basic difference. It is on you as the operator to decide what you will do to that particular group of channels. This was it for this video. Let me know in the comments below how you use DCAs and groups for your own work. And while you're doing that, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and visit gainmedialab.com for more audio deliciousness. Until next time, mix great shows. Take care. Bye.